The state of Israel has many advocates in the White House, but none have shown greater advocacy for nor greater effort to advance the special relationship between Israel and the United States and the cause of regional peace than my good friend Jared Kushner. Mr. Kushner will now offer his thoughts on this historic moment.
Thank you, Ambassador Friedman. You've really done a great job today, and you've done a great job as an ambassador, but today's really been spectacular, so thank you very much. I am so proud to be here today in Jerusalem, the eternal heart of the Jewish people. And I am especially honored to be here today as a representative of the 45th President of the United States, Donald J. Trump. I also want to thank Prime Minister Netanyahu and Sarah for being with us here today to celebrate this historic occasion. Thank you very much. I'd like to ask all of the members of Congress who are here on their delegations to rise and be recognized. Today would not be possible without your advocacy throughout the years. Thank you, Deputy Secretary Sullivan, for leading our delegation, Secretary Mnuchin, for your leadership and for your friendship, and of course, Ivanka, thank you for all the great work you do to help so many people in our country and throughout the world, including me. So I love you. I also want to acknowledge Vice President Mike Pence for his tireless efforts to strengthen the U.S.-Israel relationship. In December of last year, President Trump announced to the world that the United States would finally recognize the truth, that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. He also declared that we would soon move our embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, and just 5 months later, we are standing on these grounds. While presidents before him have backed down from their pledge to move the American embassy once in office, this president delivered, because when President Trump makes a promise, he keeps it. But today also demonstrates American leadership. By moving our embassy to Jerusalem, we have shown the world once again that the United States can be trusted. We stand with our friends and our allies. And above all else, we've shown that the United States of America will do what's right, and so we have. Israel's a sovereign nation with the right to determine its own capital, the same right that is enjoyed by every other country in the world. In taking this action, the United States has also chosen to strengthen the bond between our two countries. Our special bond is the envy of nations throughout the world. This bond is forged through shared history, sustained through shared interests, and immortalized through shared principles. The United States stands with Israel because we both believe in freedom. We stand together because we both believe in human rights. We stand together because we believe democracy is worth defending. And the United States stands with Israel because we believe we know that it is the right thing to do. When we stand together for the principles and the values we share, we shine a light of justice unto the world. Israel proves every day the boundless power of freedom. This land is the only land in the Middle East in which Jews, Muslims, and Christians, and people of all faiths participate and worship freely according to their beliefs. Israel protects women's rights, freedom of speech, and the right of every individual to reach their God-given potential. These are the same values that the United States cherishes. These are the values that bind us together. These are also the values that have made Israel one of the most vibrant nations in the world. This tiny population has spurred advancements in technology, medicine, and agriculture, making the world a healthier, safer, and more prosperous place. These are the blessings we hope Israel can one day share with its neighbors. Last week, President Trump acknowledged another truth and kept another promise. He announced his intention to exit the dangerous, flawed, and one-sided Iran deal. Iran's aggression threatens the many peace-loving citizens throughout the region and the entire world. From Israel to Jordan to Egypt to Saudi Arabia and beyond, many leaders are fighting to modernize their countries and create better lives for their people. In confronting common threats and in pursuit of common interests, previously unimaginable opportunities and alliances are emerging. I am also proud to be here today as a member of the team that President Trump has entrusted to lead the efforts to bring peace between the Israelis and the Palestinians. It has been an honor to work with our new Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo. National Security Advisor, John Bolton. Our Ambassador, David Friedman. And our special representative, Jason Greenblatt, who really does so much great work. I also want to acknowledge Ambassador Nikki Haley, who really has created a new day for Israel at the UN. On December 6th, President Trump was very clear that his decision and today's celebration do not reflect a departure from our strong commitment to lasting peace, a peace that overcomes the conflicts of the past in order to give our children a brighter and more boundless future. As we have seen from the protests of the last month and even today, those provoking violence are part of the problem and not part of the solution. The United States is prepared to support a peace agreement in every way that we can. We believe that it is possible for both sides to gain more than they give so that all people can live in peace, safe from danger, free from fear, and able to pursue their dreams. The United States recognizes the sensitivity surrounding Jerusalem, a city that means so much to so many. Jerusalem is a city unique in the history of civilization. No other place on earth can claim significance to three major religions. Each day, Jews pray at the Western Wall, Muslims bow in prayer at Al-Aqsa Mosque, and Christians worship at the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. That is why President Trump has called many times, including right now, on all parties to maintain the status quo at Jerusalem's holy sites, including the Temple Mount, also known as Haram al-Sharif. While the challenges to peace are numerous, I have personally seen that the determination of the leaders in the region and throughout the world remains steadfast. They have seen too much pain, sorrow, and wasted opportunity, and they think it's time to try something better. Throughout history, Jerusalem has been the victim of war and conquest. It has been used to divide people and to instigate conflict by those with evil intentions, but it does not have to be this way. Jerusalem must remain a city that brings people of all faiths together, to visit, to worship, to respect each other, and to appreciate the majesty of history and the glory of God's creation. Israel has been a responsible custodian of Jerusalem and has kept these religious sites open to all. In fact, immediately after the 1967 war, one of the first acts of the Knesset was to adopt the Protection of Holy Places Law, ensuring access to places of worship to members of all religions. Funds were immediately allocated to repair any damage to the churches, mosques, and synagogues that suffered through war, conflict, and neglect. As Israel turns 70, the search for a lasting peace turns over a new leaf, one of realism and of not being afraid to stand strongly with our allies for what is good, for what is right, and for what is true. When there is peace in this region, we will look back upon this day and remember that the journey to peace started with a strong America recognizing the truth. The pursuit of peace is the noblest pursuit of humankind. I believe peace is within reach if we dare to believe that the future can be different from the past, that we are not condemned to relive history, and that the way things were is not how they must forever be. It will not be an easy road, and it will be filled with difficult moments and tough decisions, but if we dream big, if we lead with courage, we can change the trajectory for millions from hopeless to boundless. This is a hope that many of us know personally. I am here today as a proud American and the grandson of Holocaust survivors. During World War II, my late grandparents, Ray and Joseph Kushner, fled their homes to the forests of Belarus to escape Nazi persecution. Somehow, they managed to resist the horrors and survive. After the war, they built a new life in America, a beacon of hope, a land of limitless opportunity. In my office in the White House, I keep a photo of them on my desk to remind me of how high the stakes are when nations fail to recognize right from wrong and the decisive power America has to tip the scales in favor of the righteous. Today, we take another historic step in that direction. I am confident that as a result, our nations will be stronger, our peoples more prosperous, and our futures filled with even greater promise for peace. May God bless you. May God bless Israel. May God bless the United States of America.
Jared just referred to his two grandparents who survived the Holocaust. To the Holocaust.